Dear children, so welcome to the session. The last class we discussed about the lesson, that is acid, bases and salt. Let me continue that lesson. So in the last class we just give the introduction about what is in the acids, bases and what is in the indicators. So acid means it is a sour taste, base means bitter taste, and acid, if we add water in the acid, means it releases H plus ions. If we add water in the bases, means it will release the hydroxyl ions, that is OH minus ions. And the indicators are used to identify whether the given solution is acid or base. We have to identify that. It will change when we add the indicator, the acid and bases, means it will change the color. So from that we can easily identify whether the given chemical is acid or bases. Let me continue with that. That is, first is olfactory indicators. So olfactory indicators is nothing but substance whose odor changes in acidic or basic media are called olfactory indicators. So when we add the olfactory indicators, means it will change the odor, the smell, it will change. So from that we can easily identify whether it's acidic or basic medium. So for example, so there are some olfactory indicators are there. The first one is onion, and second indicator is vanilla, and third indicator is cloves. So these are all the olfactory indicators. So olfactory indicators means nothing, it is a substance whose odor means smell, changes in acidic or basic medium. So what are the principles of olfactory indicators? So these olfactory indicators should work on the principle when an acid or bases is added, and then its characteristic smell can be detected. So when we add the olfactory indicators in acid or bases, so from that it will give some smell. So from that we can detect whether it will be the acid or bases. So these are the principles of olfactory indicators. Okay, let me see one activity. So what observation do you notice when few drops of dilute HCl solution is added a cloth strips with odor of onion, and few drops of sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH solution, is added on another cloth strip with odor of onion? So what did you observe? So when we add the cloth strips, when we add the dilute HCl solution with onion in one cloth, and in another cloth you have to add sodium hydroxide. The sodium hydroxide formula is NaOH. So with that, the odor of onion is there. What did you observe? So the onion has a characteristic smell. So onion has a characteristic smell. When a base like sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH, is added to the cloth strip treated with onion extract, then the smell is destroyed. So when we add sodium hydroxide and we have to treat with the onion extract. If the base is there, means we can't able to feel the smell of onion. So here the smell is destroyed. And acid solution does not destroy the smell of onion. So in acid solution, it will not destroy the smell of onion. So with that we can easily identify. You have to take the two different cloth. In that cloth you have to add HCl. In another cloth we have to add sodium hydroxide, and we have to add some onion in that both cloth. So in one cloth, the odor of onion, the smell of onion is destroyed. We can't able to feel the smell of onion. That means the cloth is dipped with sodium hydroxide solution. If the cloth is have the acidic solution with odor of onion, so we can feel the smell of onion. So from that we can easily identify the acid and bases. So acid means the smell of onion will not destroy. Base means the smell of onion will destroy. So with that two observation we can easily identify whether the solution is acidic or basic. And next activity is take about 5 ml of dilute sulfuric acid in a test tube and add a few pieces of zinc granules to it. So we have to take 5 ml of dilute sulfuric acid. What is the formula for sulfuric acid, children? Yes, H2SO4. So we have to take the dilute sulfuric acid in a test tube, and with that we have to add a few pieces of zinc granules. So this is the test tube. So in the test tube we have to add dilute sulfuric acid, and after that we have to add the zinc granules. So this is the test tube stand, and we have to fit with the cork, and we have to close it with the cork. So with that the hydrogen gas will be liberated. So that hydrogen gas, it will be connected with the delivery tube. So the hydrogen gas is come and it will enter into the soap solution. What do you observe when acid like HCl, HNO3 and CH3COOH is taken instead of sulfuric acid? So here when we take the zinc granules with dilute sulfuric acid, so here what is the equation it will be formed? First we will write the equation. So what is the formula for zinc? Zn plus dilute H2SO4. Dilute H2SO4. Dilute H2SO4, it will form zinc sulfate is at an SO4 plus hydrogen gas is liberated. So this hydrogen gas, it will come with the delivery tube and it will pass into the soap solution. The question is, instead of dilute H2SO4, when we take the acids like HCl, HNO3 and acetic acid, what do you observe? The same observation is seen when sulfuric acid is replaced with HCl, HNO3 or acetic acid. The same reaction it will be obtained. So, the general thing is, when we add metal with acid, means it will form the salt plus hydrogen gas is liberated. So, here when we take in presence of zinc with HCl, what will forms? Yes, zinc chloride is at an Cl2 plus hydrogen gas is liberated. So, here when we take instead of dilute H2SO4, here we have to take dilute HNO3. What will happen? It will form zinc nitrate. Is at an NO3 twice zinc nitrate plus hydrogen gas is liberated. So, when we take acetic acid, what is the formula for acetic acid? CH3COOH. So, when we take the acetic acid with presence of zinc, so what does it forms? It forms zinc acetate. The zinc acetate formula is at an CH3COO twice. It is the zinc acetate formula plus hydrogen gas is liberated, H2. So, the same reaction will be time. So, what gas is liberated? Hydrogen gas is liberated. So, general thing is, when we add acid with the presence of metal, it will form salt plus hydrogen gas is liberated. Okay, children, see you on next session.